Hello everyone! Today I want to show you these NVA 7x40 binoculars. These binoculars were produced in the 60s or 70s by Zeiss for the Sichtkreuzer for the East German Army. NVA stands for National People's Army. These binoculars have single layer coating. You see the lenses are already somewhat worn and the coating is also damaged. The outer lens of the eyepiece has a tiny chip. I think it won't affect the image quality, but the appearance is compromised. This binocular has an infrared membrane, similar. More precisely, I think that this is the original, and the Soviet binoculars by 8x30 is a copy. And there is also illumination here. The reticle illumination, which is located in the right half. I still don't know how this illumination is made here. How the light gets in, I haven't figured it out yet. And in general, what to use for lighting? Should I use a simple flashlight? Or do I need some more focused light here? Well, I will try to experiment. Now I will completely disassemble it. First, I will remove this cover. And I want to tell you that this binocular is very, very similar to the Scepter M. Cesar 740. Wilson, this T, then this T. In general, these binoculars are considered to be very high quality. The price for them, on average, if they are in very good condition, can range from $200 to $300. And after the 1970s, similar binoculars, also 7x40, but with roof prisms, began to be produced. They were also produced by Carl Zeiss. The binoculars were called EDF 7x40 and DF 700. They are much more expensive, but also of higher quality, with multi-layer coating, and their price can be as high as $800 to $1,000. Very similar binoculars to these or their copies were produced in Romania, known as IOR binoculars, or in Yugoslavia, known as ZRAK. ZRHK, Abuzar. Disassembling the binoculars is quite simple. First, unscrew. This ring, there is a sealing rubber here. Next, the body with the lens. It also unscrews quite easily. After that, this cover. There is a sealant here. It seems to me that it is still quite good. I will try to press it here in the corner and use it again. Next, the prisms. You see, the prism block is essentially a copy of the Septarum. There are also these screws with an offset center, which additionally hold the prism and allow for some adjustment to ensure the angle between the two prisms is 90 degrees. Disassembly is much easier than in Oberkochen. There to remove these two prisms, you really have to bend them. Everything is more complicated with them. We take out the prisms. Here they are. You can see the smoke on them. And further, on the right half, there is a grid. Here it is located. Probably it needs to be taken out and cleaned from this side. And here is another similar part. There is probably a mirror here. It can be illuminated. Now it needs to be unscrewed. Something here is a little bit more dirty. I am not entirely sure if I can clean it at all. How exactly do I unscrew the eyepiece? Essentially the same as in old Zeiss models from 20, 30 years ago. There is a ring here. For these years, there is a ring here. You need to align the hole like this, for example the layout, and push this side. Then help yourself. Unscrewing. Here, eyepiece. and the grid is also dirty and will also need to be removed. So look here at what I unscrewed. Here it is. The hole where the light hits the grid, you need to screw it in such a way that, make sure this hole aligns right here, see? Then the backlight will work. The eyepiece is essentially the same as in the Septarimi. It is quite clean. So, well, I won't take out this middle lens. Well, it's just not necessary. I have already started assembling the binoculars a bit. Look here. I have cleaned the prisms on both the left and right sides. They have a light coating on the prism covers. The sealant is intact. I just moved it a bit like this. I think it will be fine. Now, regarding the objective lens, it's quite simple. We unscrew the retaining ring, remove the sleeve, and the adjustment ring can also be taken off. There's some kind of mass here. I don't know. I'll wipe everything here and do it differently. From the inside, unscrew another retaining ring and remove the lens. Reassemble everything and put it back together. There's nothing particularly difficult or unusual about this. Well, I reassembled the binoculars again. Of course, I wish the coating on the lenses was better preserved. There are scratches, and the coating is quite severely damaged. The chip on the eyepiece essentially does not affect the image quality because it is on the outer lens and on the side, but it does affect the appearance somewhat. There is also a wreath like this, protection for the eyepiece. There should have been a filter here. I saw on the internet that they are green. Well, as you can see, it's a pity there isn't one. Now, as soon as I take some shots with it, I can tell you right away the image is very, very pleasing to the eye. So at first, it shoots through the left half. Well, this defect is somewhat noticeable. Through the phone camera, but almost. Invisible to the naked eye. If there were a chip on the lens of the objective, it would distort the image. But since it's on the eyepiece outside, it's simple. But what if it catches the eye and ruins the appearance? Now about the image quality. The picture here is quite Soviet, meaning the colors and overall clarity. Everything is at a fairly high level, like in the 1970s, and it's pleasant for the eyes to look. The depth of field is simply enormous. I don't really understand why you need to refocus the image in these binoculars. They could have made the eyepieces fixed. If you compare with Soviet binoculars from those times up to the 90s, they don't even come close to the quality of these binoculars. If anyone has the same binoculars but Romanian or Yugoslavian, please write in the comments whether they are exact copies or if there are any differences. Thank you for watching the video. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up and see you next time.